Hi, what's up? My name is Rye Reed, the writer. All right, I found this wonderful video on TikTok, so we're most definitely going to be watching this. Rejection. It sucks. I have faced my fair share of rejection, and it hurts. Like, hey, let me take a sip to that. I found this video. It's by this author. Her name is Elise Kova. You may have heard of her if you're in like the book world, if you're an author, if you like reading like fiction fantasy, or maybe you've seen her book covers on TikTok if you're into books and stuff. But she's pretty famous. She's world renowned. Her books are all over the world. And I think her little video is something that would benefit a lot of you out there, especially like if you're wanting to be an artist and you're facing your first round of like no's, because like those first no's hurt like a, but it hurts so freaking much, like to your core. So watch this video. We're gonna talk about it once you're done and we're gonna come back. Go ahead.
I got that adrenaline, get 'em, got going with 'em. Never gonna slow up in 'em, ready to snap any momentum.
So there's a lot to digest with that, but before we get started, because y'all know what I gotta do. I gotta do a little side pitch on myself. I gotta promote my own stuff. You already know. I got to. You already know. Okay, so here's one of my books. It's White Orchids. It just came in the mail probably 2 days ago, so it's super clean. It's not dented. But yeah, if you wanna support me and support this channel, go ahead and like, subscribe. My friend's gonna be like, make sure you say that. I said it. Like and subscribe. Follow, and if you want to buy one of these books, my books are like poetry based, they're motivational, they're really good. And you know, you gotta support chocolate writers out here. Yes, I said that. I am chocolate. Like, don't even trip. Back to the video. You believe that? As soon as I saw a video, I was watching it 2 a.m. at night. As I always do, I'm always looking for videos for you guys, like some inspiration and whatnot. The author popped up on my feed and I was scrolling. I was like, okay, let me just randomly just watch this. Because I'm just that person. On TikTok, I just keep scrolling. But I stopped on this and I felt like, man, like that's such a freaking sign. I feel like so many people need to like understand that rejection is part of like your process. It's part of your story. You have to get rejected. Like, it freaking sucks getting those no's. The whole point of it is, and this is like my belief, this is just me. I believe rejection does a couple of things. Rejection tells you where you're not supposed to be. Like, just like let that settle in for like a little bit. Rejection tells you where you're not supposed to be. Because you'll think like, oh, I wanted this so bad. And I wanted to say if you're an author like me, I wanted to get published through that publishing house. I wanted that agent. If you're a musician, I wanted that producer. I wanted to be part of that label. I wanted that artist to notice me. You know what I'm talking about? Like, you want it so bad. And when you get that no, you think that you're the problem. Like, it's not for you. Majority of the time, it's not for you because it's not meant for you. Like, you might not even realize you getting that no might be the blessing in disguise that was part of your destiny, part of your story. Because the thing you wanted isn't what was meant for you. It's not yours. If you can catch my drip. Like, there's something better for you. And it's only one house up. But you have to get rejected here so you'll keep walking to that other blessing that's 10 times better. You're gonna make more money, you're gonna have more connections, you're gonna meet more people, your name's going to go out like in bigger venues, but you have to get that no way down here. So you'll push yourself to work harder. And that's just for me. I feel like I'm just that person where if you tell me no, I'm not going to accept the defeat. I used to be that person. I used to just be like, oh, it's fine. That's cool. It's, you know, it's just, I used to cry about it. Now I just go, okay, all right, that's a no from you. Now I'm going to go find my yes somewhere else. But I love that video, though, like of Elise Kova. Really cool name. I saw her book maybe a few years ago, and I thought it was absolutely beautiful, but I didn't know her testimony. I didn't know what she went through. And could you imagine, like, her books are fantastic. I don't know if you guys saw in the video. I'll just kind of, like, bring it up. She is, she published 25 plus books. I'm sure it's more, like, now. She was on USA's Today, and she's on the best sellers list. But she was rejected. Just to think, like, that agent that said no to her, that publishing house that would not want to take the risk on her. Like, looking at it now, they could have made millions off her in the beginning, but she just took it on herself to continue on with her journey. Really like that. Then I like that for 7 years, she stayed in the mud. And that's another like important thing to keep in mind if you're an artist, if you want to start a business, if you have an idea and you want to jump on it, you want to travel or whatever it is, you're going to be in the mud. What I mean by mud, not like physically in the mud, but mud as in you're going to have your hardships. You're going to struggle. You're going to like fight to get what you want. Because whatever you want in life, it's, and I'm rambling for this video, so just like bear with me. I'm just going like off the dome. I usually have like notes, but I'd rather just talk to you guys and drink my little drink here, my little energy drink, and just like talk to you. But you know what I mean? It's just, you're going to struggle and it's going to hurt and you're gonna have to put in a couple years. And it's always like that for like a lot of famous people. They didn't get where they're at like overnight. There are overnight successes, but what we think is overnight is actually them doing 10 years of work before they even got there. Like one person I always like comes to my mind when I think of that is like Justin Bieber. Justin Bieber blew up when he was like, what, 14, 15? It's like when he got really huge. And I was young too. I was in middle school when he was like popping off. And I thought he was so young. Me and Justin Bieber were like the same age. I thought he was like a little boy. I didn't know that me and him were like both little kids at the time. You know what I'm saying? When you're a little girl, you'd be like, man, little boy, I don't want that. I want Chris Brown with that grown man. But yeah, Justin Bieber, he, for like the first few years of his like career, it didn't start with him doing Baby, 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 that song. I'm not going to sing it for like copyright purposes, but it didn't start with him singing with Usher and dancing and him wearing that purple hat and rocking those clothes. It really started with him getting on his guitar, practicing, learning how to play music at his home with his mother, singing. Like, they had a couple of videos of Justin Bieber like watching TV, watching, like listening to like Usher, like way back in the day, and him singing in his living room. And you know, his family, they weren't rich, they weren't balling. Like, his mother was struggling with him, his dad wasn't really involved in his life, but that was him, that was his journey. Then it evolved to him getting brave enough and feeling his passion, feeling his giftings, knowing that this is what I'm supposed to do on this planet. I'm supposed to sing. Going in front of, there's a video, I'll have to see if I can find it inserted in here. You're my God and my Father. You're forever the same. How could I feel so empty now? Why speak your name? But there's a video of Justin Bieber singing on, like, I believe it's a library, on a step, and it looked cold outside because this is Canada is cold, of him singing outside playing his guitar. And like, you might have one or two people who might slow down to like look at him, but for the most part, people are just walking past, and here you have Justin Bieber singing his heart out. That's like the journey. That's what it is, being in the mud. So for Elise Kova, for 7 years, she was in the mud. She had to figure out how to get her books published. She had to do it herself. She had to figure out how to get an editor, how to make a book cover, before she even got to that level to where she is now, where she sold millions of books. Like, millions. Like, come on now. That's what it is, being in the mud. And that's what I'm saying. These like little stories are so important for you, so you know that the no you're going to face, that rejection, is not your ending point. It's actually your starting point. Some highlights from the video, like some takeaways that like I really felt in my body, my spirit, to tell you, is there will always be gatekeepers that are going to get in the way of you wanting to go to the next level. There's always going to be that somebody who's going to look at your talent and not understand what it is. The thing about like the entertainment industry, and even like if you're an athlete, or say if you're you want to build a building or whatever, there are always people in the way of allowing you to go and do that thing that you want to do. Like in the book industry world, they're called agents. You have a book idea, you have to write it first, get it cleaned up, make sure it's presentable. Then you send your book copy to an agent. And this agent has to determine within themselves if this book is good enough to take to the mainstream market. Like if this book will sell. They have to think about all these things. Like, will it sell? Is there a marketplace for it? Will people have an interest in it? Is a possibility that this book can like generate money? Like, because it's a business. Whatever you do, it's a business. The agent has to pitch this book, if they like it, to a publishing house. So the publishing house also has to go through all those criteria. They have to go, is this going to make money? Do we have books similar to this? Will the market accept this? Does it fit the season right now? There's so many dimensions before you can get to that other phase. There's so many people who have to be on board. Those are just gatekeepers. You get into a position where like the gatekeeper, the first one or the second one, says no to you, you have to accept that. Also, you have to understand that what you like is not what everyone else is going to like. What you're into is not always going to be even mainstream. I think of an artist, I think of like J.K. Rowling. When she was putting out Harry Potter, there were no sorcery books. Like, magic was not like a big popping thing. Even before that, there were some books that kind of detailed that. Wizards, there were no wizards going happening in the 80s and 90s. Like, nobody was like going, man, I want to be a wizard. Like, it's cool now. Like, now you got people out here like trying to be wizards and fairies and whatever. But back in the day, it was not as mainstream. She had that vision, she had that idea, she put it forward. And she also felt, you know, went through major rejections at the time. You can't really worry about these gatekeepers too much, because their opinion is not always the market. They don't know what talent really is until it's proven by the market. It's proven by you, the viewer, the reader, the listener, the watcher, the moviegoer. We don't know what's going to happen until we put it out into the market. These people, they operate in a state of fear. They don't know what's going to happen. All they're worried about is like the end line. Will this make money? Can I do this? Can I get behind it? A lot of talent and a lot of art gets dropped and never seen. And the talent that gets dropped could be the greatest thing on the planet, which a lot of the times it is. Because we don't find out how great these people were until after get famous. But before then, we find out about all the rejection they went through. We go, how come that wasn't put out sooner? Like, that was hot. You agents, you know, like you gatekeepers, you had no clue what this was, because you just don't know. You don't know what's great until it's great. That's the key one right there. And another takeaway is to do it for yourself and do it by yourself. You face the rejection, screw it, just do it on your own. You can do anything. I really want to say that, like, you can honestly do whatever you want on this planet. there are no limitations. I don't care how old you might think you are, how short, if you're black, you're white, you're Chinese, if you identify as being a robot, you really can do whatever it is that you want to do on this planet. Like, there's really nothing stopping you. You have the ability. You just have to make a way for yourself. The idea is so strong and it sticks and you have enough faith in it, figure it out. When I was starting my writing career, I also faced like so many rounds of rejections. Like Elise, Kova, I think she faced like 111. I was in the 200s. My behind, I was out here pitching my book to people in different countries, French, European market. I was trying to get an agent from Canada to like represent me, because all the American agents, literary agents, all told me no, or they never got back to me. So I sent out so many book requests. I loved my book so much that I said, forget it. If I have to do this on my own, then I'm just going to figure it out. And I did. I had to figure out how to make a book cover, how to put a book together, how to market, how to get on social media, how to promote myself. I was not going to do that, then I would have never been in the position that I am now, where I'm actually able to sell books every day. I sell books every freaking day. I make profit. If I would have accepted that no back in the day and just said forget it, I never would have got to this point. Just fighting. So do it yourself. Take the no's, find another path. If there's a freaking blockage in this one road right here, hey, what? There's more roads out there. Find another road, find another detour, go a different way. Don't give up on it. Keep moving. Get that no? Hey, I gotta go. That's it. You just wipe your little eyebrows off of it, brush your hair, brush your teeth, cry a little bit, go get some Wingstop like I do, and just keep it moving, keep it pushing. I have a list of authors. It's gonna be short, but it's a short list of authors that were rejected early on in their career, and their books are sold millions. And I'm sure those agents, looking back, the ones that rejected them, are punching the ground, because they're probably looking back like, damn, I rejected that person and that book. Now that book is so well renowned that everyone wants to read it, so I'll be freaking pissed. But here's a list of authors that have been rejected. Sit back, relax, and I'm gonna put the article link down below so you can check it out and read it just for like motivational purposes. I found this article. It's by Authors Publish. It was written by Emily Harstone. It's called 13 Famous Authors Who Were Rejected. I'm not gonna read all of the article. I'm gonna allow you guys to do that on your own. I'm gonna go over just some of the major authors that I like, that I'm very much aware of, for you to go through motivation from. Theodore Seuss, Gizelle. I'm sure I'm saying his last name completely wrong. Dr. Seuss, this is who he is. Better known as Dr. Seuss, had his first book, Mulberry Street, rejected 27 times before it was accepted. Catherine Stockett's book, The Help, was rejected by 60 literary agents. Thank goodness for agent number 61. Thank God. Sylvia Plath was already a known poet by the time she published The Bell Jar under the pseudonym. It was rejected even once the publisher found out who the author really was. You can actually read the rejection letter here, so it's pretty cool. You can actually go through that on the article. Beatrix Porter was rejected so many times, she initially self-published The Tale of Peter Rabbit. Then it was picked up by the publisher Frederick Warren and Co. for a trade edition. Stephen King had already published a number of shorter works when he wrote and attempted to publish his first novel, Carrie. Carrie was rejected by 30 publishers before it was accepted. William L. Golding's Lord of the Flies, a high school reading list staple, was rejected 20 times before it was accepted for publication. And one of the 15 publishers that rejected Anne Frank's diary wrote, "The girl doesn't, it seems to me, have a special perception or feeling which would lift the book above the curiosity level. Wow. I'm telling you, the Lord of the Flies was rejected. Come on now. So there you go. That's the list. Dr. Seuss was rejected. On Mulberry Street, that was my classic. My mom used to read that book to me when I was a little girl. I love that book so freaking much. There's so many authors that were like rejected that weren't even mentioned. People, like I said, people don't know. We don't know what's good until we find out that it's great. That's essentially it. Don't take the rejection personally. Nobody knows what you're made of until you put it out there. Just put it out there and see what happens. You never know. You could be the next J.K. Rowling. You could be the next Dr. Seuss. Just be brave enough to find a way, be consistent in it, and find your yes. But I hope that video like motivated you. It motivated me definitely to keep writing, to not take it personally, to stay on my craft. That's really it. Over time, if you keep watering the same seed, it will bloom, right? That's like fantastic. Y'all have a great day today. Make sure you follow, like, and share, subscribe. Like I said, if you want to support me and my books, go ahead and check them out. My books are available on Amazon, Apple, and Barnes & Noble. Rye Read right there, right? But yeah, you guys have a great day. I'm going to continue working. Yay! I'm gonna keep drinking this drink. It looks so suspect. It looks so freaking bad. But it tastes good. It's keeping me awake. Hey.